Assalamu alaikum everyone. Today we are going to discuss about the third experiment, which is the conventional lathe experiment. Our objective is to identify the lathe machine and its functionality, identify the different parts of the lathe machine, and later we will manufacture a workpiece. So, in theory, lathe removes undesired material from a rotating workpiece in the form of chips with the help of a tool which is traversed across the work and can be fed deep in work. So, what happens in this lathe machine when compared to milling is, instead of having the spindle rotating or let's say the tool rotating, we have the workpiece rotating in the case of lathe machine. And we have a tool which is placed on a tool holder, which you will see later in the figure, which is forced through in order to, let's say, remove material from this rotating workpiece. The tool material should be harder than the workpiece and the later held securely and rigidly on the machine. The tool may be given linear motion in any direction. A lathe is used principally to produce cylindrical surfaces and plane surfaces at right angles to the axis of rotation. It can also produce tappers and bellows, etc. The components of the lathe machine, we can see it in the next slide. So these are the components which are present in the lathe machine. This is the headstock, this part here. The spindle speed selection can be done here. The spindle is attached here. The feed selector is here. The clutch is here. Chip pan is here. So whatever chips that are formed, it will be collected here. This device is called the apron. There is a split nut, longitudinal and traverse feed control. So longitudinal, again, it is to move left and right in this case, and traverse is to move in and out of the machine. So this machine basically is a two-axis machine, it's not three-axis machine. There is a clutch, a feed rod, lead screw, bed, the tailstock assembly is here. There is a hand wheel attached to the tailstock assembly, and there is a tailstock quill. Again, quill is to attach any kind of tool, let's say to do the tapering of edges or the bellow operation. There is the dead center. This is also to control the center of the workpiece. These are called ways. This is the carriage. And the cross slide and the compound wrist, and here is the tool post where the tool will be attached. There are a set of sequence of operations for step turning. Step turning is a process of reducing the diameter of the object in steps. So the first step in this process is centering. So before starting the operation, we have to ensure that the workpiece is centered. So how you have attached it to the chuck, it has to be done in such a way that the object is centered. We don't want it to wobble. The workpiece should not wobble. It has to be a steady rotation. The second step is facing. So for example, once you have cut out a certain amount of the workpiece, the edge will not be smooth necessarily. So you have to do facing, which is to just remove a layer from the initial part of the workpiece in order to make it a smooth surface. Then comes plane turning. Plane turning is to remove a little bit of the outer diameter of the workpiece. This is because the workpiece generally is stored in a location which would be dusty, or let's say it could be, in case of metals, the outer shell could be rusty as well. So in order to remove this, we do plane turning. Then there are other options which include chamfering, step turning, grooving and taper turning. So these are done for finishing touches. The step turning is our main process where we have to remove all the material. Chamfering is done, let's say if you want to have a chamfered edge at the end of the workpiece, you can do that, or at the beginning of the workpiece. Grooving can be done using the tailstock if you want to make a groove inside the workpiece. It can be done, and also there is taper turning. There is another operation which you can do, which is for threading. So in order to create any kind of bolts, it can be done using the lathe machine. So again, the steps are the same, but you have two other steps which include the thread cutting, which is how to do the threading. You have to use a specific tool, and there is a specific control for doing the threading operation, which is located below the headstock. And once you adjust those parameters, you can decide the pitch, which is the distance between two threads, the size of the depth of the thread, etc. So all these parameters can be changed in the machine to get the desired type of thread process done. And this is an automatic process. It is not done manually, the threading process. Then there is the knurling process. Safety rules. These safety rules are similar to the one that was mentioned in the milling lecture. So if you want more details about this, you can go back to that video. Again, these rules are all applicable for both milling and lathe. Part to be manufactured. In this case, you have a cylindrical nylon rod. So this nylon rod has a diameter of 25 millimeters. So your objective is to change that workpiece into this shape, which is shown in the slide here. So what you have to do is, initially you are provided with something which is 25 mm, which is, it should be this big at least. You will reduce its diameter for 20 mm for a distance of 10 plus 10 plus 10, 30 mm. So once you're done with making the surface 20 mm, you have to come back, make this one 14 mm for 20 distance and 10 mm for 10 distance. Again, you cannot go directly to 20 from 25, you have to go in steps. So you have to go, let's say, from 25 to 23, 23 to 21, and then 21 to 20, 20 to 18, 20 to 16, 20 to 14, 14 to 12, 14 to 10. So it has to be done in stages, or else what will happen, the tool holder might break off, or the workpiece will start to wobble because you are trying to remove a lot of material at the same time. So in order to do this, you have to do it in a slow manner because the material we are using is nylon. So it is a very soft material. So the process has to be slow. If you were using aluminum, the RPM of the machine has to be higher.